Oh, this is funky. Oh, Said is with his hands today. We don't see Said's head. two hands and head. That's awesome. Hi, friends. Welcome. We're waiting for everyone to join. You have full controls over the music at the bottom of your screen. And do let me know, what is your energy level today? No, Erica, no. And that balloon has the same color as your blouse. What's your energy level today? Where are we? Ready to fly, deflated? I have a cold on. It's that time of the year again. Hopefully not COVID. I forgot COVID was a thing. And then last week, two of my colleagues were like, out. Okay, Chris and I are towards the lower, like high end. That's great, Chris. Natalie, Madia, Oliver, Irina, Diana, they're towards the lower side of the. Okay, cool. Well, welcome everyone to the Facilitation Sandbox. If you have been joining us in past edition, you know what this is all about. Experiments. Prepare to be surprised. Anything and everything can go wrong, and that's okay. These sessions are about experiments, are about us leaning into a new concept, different tools, different ways of facilitating, just expanding our comfort zone as facilitators, quite frankly, in a safe space with other like-minded people. And we're spending the next hour together and we're talking about hand gestures, and Chris will tell us all about that. This session actually originated in the last socializing session that we had. There was a lot of chatter around this. Like Erica was there, I think Said was there. So it was just we talked a lot about this and we were like, let's deep dive into this funky topic, and Chris was open to it. So that's what we're doing here today. I want to do a quick pulse check. Do drop your locations in the chat. That's awesome. I want to do a quick pulse check regarding the tool that we're in here today. Do you butter? So again, hover over the flashcard that you see on the screen and you can simply click on it. Do you know butter, had a little taste, or smooth sailing? I'm an expert. I've been in sessions. I know how to use this tool, etc. You will not have to facilitate today. I'm curious if, you know, you've been here before, you're familiar with the interface, or if we have to do a quick onboarding tool on. So I see Jason, it's towards the, what is that? Well, Jason, welcome to Butter. We are in Butter now. And basically, I'm just going to do a super quick, fast intro to the tool so we make sure that we're all on the same page here. You find all the commands to the left side of the screen. We have the reaction, which you can all hit it and use them throughout the sessions. We're going to use mainly our hands today, but you can use the reactions. We have our cue for Q&As and conversations. We're just structuring the way we use them. And we also have the chat right below that you can open and connect there. You can take notes directly in Butter. We have the shared notes as a default. Hey, everyone. Or you can toggle over from the top to the private notes. You can use the M hotkey for quick mute, unmute. Same goes for V. Are you ready? Natalie and me are ready. That's good. Okay, Chris is now, hand gestures. Perfect. Well, my name's Anne-Ria. I am leading the Butter Community Project and happy to be spending the next hour with y'all. And Chris, you've got the word. The floor is yours. Take it away.
Thank you, Anne-Maria. I figured since this is a little bit of an experiment and there's going to be a lot of social learning in this session, I am not an expert on hand gestures as a form of communication on any level. This is really an exploration that we'd start off with impromptu networking, because we're going to be learning from each other. I want you all to feel comfortable interacting. So we're going to go into breakout rooms for a few minutes. You'll be in a breakout room with three or four. And in there, please discuss what are some of your favorite hand signals and why do you use them? So that's the prompt. What are some of your favorite hand signals and why do you use them? Be prepared to share takeaways once you're back in the main room. Any questions about breakout rooms?
We'll be spending 7 minutes in groups of three or four. Any Italians in the room, says Erica? Any experts? Let's consider experts in hand gestures. I don't know. Okay, 7 minutes. What are the most used and what are the most used, the ones that you use the most, hand gestures?
Yeah, I put what are your favorite hand signals or hand gestures, okay. And why do you use them? And they can be in professional or personal settings. Let's go divergent here. Let's just start talking about it. This can be fun, playful.
Perfect. Have fun, everyone. See you back in Savron. Oh, by the way, if there's anything in the breakouts, mic, camera, any technical problem at all, on the right side of the screen, you have a tiny hand icon, which you can click, and I'll be jumping in the breakout with you. See you soon.
Welcome back. Saeed, we can't stop talking about your video magic.
Especially after our last session, I thought, wouldn't it be nice to have, like, camera for hand signals and everything?
Yeah.
And also, I want to annoy Anna Maria, of course.
I know. We should have collaborated on this session. Well, anyways, welcome back. I like getting quick takeaways from each room before moving on to the next session. Any takeaway from your room? Anything interesting that you can share out?
Takeaway.
Anything fun? Not fun.
No fun.
Interesting.
No fun here.
Maybe I could start. So I think there are a couple of things as the main and takeaway from our group that it's, you know, using hand gestures, it seems like even a new code of conduct or a new language that we need to establish, and it really depends on the context, how you use it, when you use it, and sort of like a contract that you sign. So that was one thing, and another. We talked about the kids, how we can translate, you know, like what we use in the school, for example, and how we can incorporate that as a fun activity as well. And yes, we had some good use of hand gestures as well during that breakout room. So that was a hands-on experience, I guess. Thanks.
Thank you. I would like to add, if I may, we are very international and intercultural group, as always. And yeah, you have to be aware that there are different meanings for hand signals in different parts of the world, or different signals for the same meaning. And also things that are maybe local. I knew it before, but we talked about like the touchdown hand signal, which is how referee signals a touchdown in American football. And if you're not into football or not American, you probably have no idea, but it means, yeah, you did it, or great touchdown goal. And I don't want to go into the depth of my example was that there is, I'm from Morocco and we show the middle finger differently. So if we show us the European middle finger or the rest of the world middle finger, probably it's not as offensive because it's not how we used to it. We use a different hand signal for it, but this is recorded. I don't want to show it.
I'm so curious now it is recorded. Yes.
Thank you, Saeed.
Okay, maybe after we close the recording, Saeed. Marianne was laughing. She's like, "That's not how we show touchdown in America."
You need to be more precise. Boom! There you go.
Well,
we also. Sorry, please.
Yeah, no, one last takeaway from our final group and then we need to move on. All right, a lot of pressure. Sometimes the pressure gets to people. Well, thank you. I hope you enjoyed that, connecting with each other. I think it's important. That's one of the reasons that we come to these sessions, to meet each other and build relationships. But time for the main activity, which we're all excited about. I know. Essentially, yeah. So as Anna Maria was talking about this topic, got a lot of reactions when we led just a brief session from the Butter Social. So we want to explore it more. The thesis is generally, I find a lot of online meetings very boring. And I think one of the reasons it's hard to express yourself without disrupting the conversation. So it can be very uncomfortable. There are chats and there are reactions. So like Butter does this, you know, I've been playing around with these reactions, which is really cool. And there are chat rooms, but sometimes, you know, it's hard to follow those, especially if you're facilitating or some participants find it hard to follow. So I don't know, we started exploring hand signals and how they might be a great way to help people express themselves in meetings, especially online, or make it more interactive and more energetic. I don't know. So it's more engaging. That's the theory. So today we're going to be jumping into a fun exercise to stimulate online engagement and self-expression through hand signals without disrupting. The idea is to help not disrupt the flow of conversations or enrich your conversations with hand signals. Exactly. This exercise isn't meant to be serious, okay? So it's meant to get everyone playing around with hand signals and having fun with them, right? So let's not overthink it. There's a little bit of improv involved, all right? We'll have a deeper reflection on the hand gestures afterwards, right? So whatever we come up with, we're going to use the hand gestures to have a deeper reflection afterwards. So let's stimulate some bold and stimulating hand gestures today in session. Sound good? All right. So essentially, we're going to be getting into teams to develop a skit, a work skit, a conversation. In this work skit, you're going to be having a conversation in your teams. There's going to be verbal conversation, and you're going to integrate hand gestures. Okay, so you'll be in groups of three or four to create the skit together. We want each team member to contribute a hand gesture. All right? So each team member contributes a hand gesture. You will be sharing the skit back in the main room afterwards. So you're going to need to practice it when you're in your breakout rooms together. There will be a winning team, and applause will determine the winning team. So applause or whatever hand gesture we have. And we're going to use the winning team's hand gestures in our reflection, right? So the winning team, we are going to use your hand gestures in our reflection activity afterwards, hopefully to have a deeper, more engaging conversation and reflection. That's the concept. We'll see if it works. This is a sandbox. All right. So we're developing this skit, but we want everyone to contribute. So to start off, we're going to take 30 seconds to brainstorm. So we're going to need a piece of paper or any way you want to note down ideas. We're going to put 30 seconds on the clock, and I want you to start thinking about brainstorming, noting. What are some hand signals to indicate emotion? So emotions might be applause, or I agree, or I'm sad. So 30 seconds on the clock, and I think we have it in the... emojis. So brainstorming emojis. Gotta use the time. All right, thank you. I know it's fast. We're moving fast, but you have more time in breakouts to develop your ideas. But we have our, all right, so we have our emotions bucket. Now let's brainstorm ideas or hand gestures for requests. What hand gestures might you use to make a request? So a request might be, I'd like to add on to that idea, or a quest might be, oh, I have a counterpoint. A quest might be, can you speak up? But some sort of request. So 30 seconds back on the clock. Bucket. Timer is nice, I'm not going to lie. I like that timer. All right, so moving fast. In our final bucket before going into breakout rooms to work in teams, let's brainstorm or note ideas for hand signals to use in meeting management. So an example for hand signals for meeting management might be 30 seconds left. Or come off mute. I don't know. Something to manage your meetings. Something to manage your meetings. This is our final bucket before going into breakout rooms. So 30 seconds on the clock. Hand gestures for meeting management. That helped kickstart your thinking. We're now going to be going into breakout rooms of teams of three or four to develop a skit, a conversation in the workplace. And I want you to incorporate an emotion, at least one emotion hand gesture, one meeting management hand gesture, and one request hand gesture. And we ideally want a contribution from each person in the room, okay? So everyone contributes. I think you get 10 minutes to practice and come up with something. You will be sharing the skit back in the main room. Applause will determine the winner. And we will be using your hand gestures in the following activity. Okay? So everyone contributes. I recommend that, you know, one person contributes a reaction, person two contributes a request, and person three contributes a meeting management hand signal. And you can maybe do that alphabetically. I'll let you figure that out. Okay. So any questions? I don't want to give too many. No. So work in teams, develop a skit. Let's try to keep the skits to 2 minutes. Is we don't have all the time in the world.
And you excited? The skits, will we using words at all or only hand gestures in those
words? Words and hand gestures. You're going to be having a conversation and improve
all
it
right.
With hand gestures.
Okay. So skit is like a play, like we're acting out a realistic piece of conversation. Okay.
A role play. Yeah. Thank you, Anna.
You will have tasks in the breakout rooms with all of the to-dos in case any of them slips your mind. And otherwise, feel free to summon us in and we'll come to rescue. Okay, 10 minutes. Have fun plotting your skits, folks. See you back in 10.
Okay, see you in 1 minute.
Welcome back. Welcome back. You used your full time limit. You used your full time limit, so you must have had fun. You must have had fun. How are we feeling? Two thumbs up if you're feeling okay. Oh boy. Okay, that's reminder, this is just supposed to be a fun, chill experience. We'll be okay. We'll be okay. So,
oh my God, I'm getting stressed out by Said and Natalie.
Do we have a volunteer team to go first? We have a volunteer team to go first. We won't do the applause until after every team is gone.
I mean, I'm tempted for us to go first just to get it out of the way.
Just do it.
Okay, who is it? Let me just panel. Let me spotlight you. We've got Kirsty. We've got Natalie. Who else was in this group?
Erin.
That's it? Was there anyone else here with you in the group?
No, Erin.
I'm going to try to note down your
hand. We're missing Irene.
Irene, were you in the group? Irene?
Yes.
Ah, there we go. Now we have the full group. Okay, cool. Have fun.
But we are feeling like this.
This is just a playful experiment.
Yeah, oh, okay. Boy. Go ahead.
Right, let's do it. Right, so we are starting our, we're going to start our meeting by introducing ourselves through the medium of our favourite food dishes. So, Irene, if you'd like to go first.
I'm not sure, but my favorite food, which is cooked around the coast of Kenya, is pilau. And I'm sure most of you have tested pilau. Yes? No? Okay. It's a really nice spicy rice that is cooked around here. It might be called something else in your areas. And yeah, that's my favorite food.
I'm gonna say Swedish meatballs from Stockholm. I have no other choice but to say that.
A quick one, Natalie. The usual meatballs, or are your meatballs different?
Hard question. I would say about this size and. Cow meat. I don't know. Yeah. they can be done like vegan too, of course, with some kind of mince, soya mince. Yeah.
Done.
Hey, thank you. All right, it's just for fun. It's just for fun. We're all winners here, by the way. We just need a winner to for the next activity. Thank you so much. So what I saw shrugging. I saw shaking no head. I saw like one finger up for like I'd like to add on a point. Or I'd like to add to that. And then I saw a thumbs up.
And the X for the end.
Okay, X for end. Okay, well, thank you.
Well done. You're done.
All right. Do we have a volunteer for the next group?
Olivier is in the spotlight. Who else is joining him?
Yeah, Diane and Marianne, I'm sorry, but it's because I will have to leave a little bit before the end. So
Diana and Marianne. Was there some confusion there, Marianne? Was there on the task I saw in the chat?
Yeah, I wasn't sure if we were being assigned a story or we were deciding what it was that we were. You said words and gestures. Were we? Was it more like a pantomime? It wasn't entirely clear what the exercise was, but I think we got it. We're good. We're good.
Okay. Well, now we're stretching our improv muscles like to the max. Is hand gestures and improv session. Two in one. Okay, the floor is yours.
Welcome, Diane. Welcome, Marianne. How are you doing? Doing okay?
Very well. We'd like to talk our meeting today to talk a little bit about using hand gestures to communicate.
We hope our highly sophisticated concept will be mind-blowing.
Wait. How? explain better.
Right. I feel that I'd like to add a little something more.
Marianne.
Oh, yes. We have only 1 minute. That's right. Appreciate that, Olivier. We really got to get moving in this scenario. And we hope that when it's all done, you will still love us.
Bye.
Thank you.
Great.
Nice.
Yeah, thank you so much. Thank you so much. That was great. Good to get some smiles too. So I saw some thumbs up. I saw a welcome hand gesture. I saw quotes. I saw add symbol. So I'd like to add on to your point. And I saw 1 minute. And I saw love you. Oh.
Mind blow. Yeah, it was mind blow.
Oh, mind blow. Okay.
Mind blow as well.
Thank you. All right. Well, thank you so much, Oliver, Diana, Miriam. Yeah, that was wonderful. Thank you. Okay.
And the timeout thingy. What's
the timeout? No, Marianne did something. I don't
plus.
Know.
I want to add something. Oh. Let me add something.
I thought it was a T.
Yeah, it was a plus. And running, we're in a hurry.
Right. So we've got Saeed, Erica, and Charla. Yes? Whoop. Erica's excited. Charla's in the car.
Sorry.
Hopefully not driving.
No, not yet.
Right.
I would like to start by saying I don't feel like a winner at all.
Everyone's a winner here, Saeed.
Wrong Natalie. Erica.
Yes. Wrong Erica. Natalie. Okay.
Pick a real name. All right, so we're definitely doing improv. And so, yeah, so this is our team and welcome everyone to Butter. If you could please unmute while we have our call. Charla, can you come off mute? You can say no or you can say yes. You're okay. I feel like the room is really, everyone's talking too much at the same time. Like, we need everyone to quiet down. Way too much, quiet down. Because we're really being mindful of time, we need everyone to wrap up your thoughts. Unless anyone disagrees and has a counterpoint about moving on. If not, then we can go ahead. What else? If everyone's happy with our decision, let us know if you're happy. And what else can I improvise? Saeed, I'll give the time to you to improvise.
The last one is a perfect segue. It's I'm really confused by everything that is happening right now. So thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Yeah, wonderful. Well, thank you, team. Yep. Let's do a quick applause to see team one of, let's see here. It was NKI, Irene, Natalie, and
Kirsty.
Okay. Round of applause for team one.
Okay. It's going to be hard to pick a winner.
Yeah, we're going to have to get really outrageous for the winning hand gesture team. How about team two? And team three. Okay, a very unscientific judge. I had team three as the winning team. So thank you very much. And Maria, did you have a winner?
Everyone's a winner in my heart.
Everyone's a winner. Okay. Yes. Very unscientific judging. Yes. And it's really the point of it was just to see if we could then use some of these hand gestures in our debrief. So
Chris is improvising the voting as well, as you can tell. There's a lot of improv today.
So let's move into our reflection time to talk about hand gestures. We can talk about the session, and we have some reflection cards. There we go. So why are hand gestures and hand signals in meetings worth talking about? You can come off mute, popcorn style, or you can put it into chat. And if you can use any hand gestures that we explored today, go ahead and use them. Yeah, that's right. Could have just done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Great point, Saeed.
Next time.
Dang it. Well, you just improved the session right there. Why is this worth talking about?
It's worth talking about because such a huge percentage of communication is body language, is what you see. And you can align the meaning of what you're saying by, or enhance it by using a gesture or a hand signal.
I love this.
I'm thinking about if you go on vacation or on a business trip to a foreign country, for example, the first thing you do is to try to explain stuff by using your hands, even the most simple words. If they don't know them, you just show things or show numbers with your hands. So it's a very international language, and I think everybody agrees on this is great, or other things. So it's reduces the language barrier, especially in this small world we are living in, since we are all virtual and very, very global.
Mm. Olivier?
Actually, right now, because we are in the small screen, that's it's better to make some gestures. to help knowing who is talking, for instance. And as a facilitator also, it's I think it's the best way to keep everybody together and attentive.
I think I'd like to emphasize this attentiveness. Now, obviously, we were very purposeful about using the hand gestures, but it was very lively and entertaining, I guess. It was very interesting to watch it, and the points came across very well. So, yeah, maybe emphasizing with linking it with Marianne said about the emphasis on something, and maybe we're also moving our bodies. Like we're constantly seated, so just moving our hands a bit and our upper body, that's also good for the brain.
Okay, on the next. So what are some of the limitations of hand gestures?
I think they could be misinterpreted. Since we're now so free to meet with people all over the world from all different cultures, I mean, we're doing that more often than ever, I think. And so just being sure that we're not being offensive.
Yeah, it reminds me of the importance to create that like shared language, or almost as ground rules if you're in a professional setting. Which, you know, it's a limitation, but it's also a great opportunity to do some team building, I see. But yeah, if you don't take advantage of that space up front, it can be a big problem, are my thoughts. Cultural differences.
I'm also thinking today we were a small group, so our faces were on the screen all the time. But if you have a bigger group and someone is gesturing and they're on the second page of Butter and you don't see them, like we're so small, right? And it's very hard to focus and see everyone at all time if the group is bigger.
I'm also noticing adoption. I don't know if it's a limitation, but my hope with today's session was not only to have a conversation, a deeper conversation, reflection on how to use hand gestures and hand signals. I was kind of hoping that the group would start adopting hand gestures as we did this reflection. And I've seen a few, but I'm mainly still seeing just like digital reactions and requests. And I don't know if that's just because we're all Butter users, but I was kind of hoping to see like a plus one, like I want to add on to that, or like I've got a counterpoint. I was kind of hoping to see that. So I don't know if that's a limitation, but there's definitely some behaviors that need to change. Okay. And then final question. Oh, we have 3 minutes left. Let's do one quick, and then we have a very quick closing activity. Oh, what hand signals are universal? We have this international crew. Oh, yeah, if you're in a car, it's hard to do. What hand signals are you? Heart.
Interestingly, I read that people, when they have a success, like a huge win, you know how you go, as we said, like the touchdown, people go throw their arms up in the air. It turns out even blind people who have never seen that gesture use that gesture when they have a huge success. So that's as universal as it gets, I think.
Yeah, it's interesting.
I'm not an expert, of course I'm not, but I think there are hand signals from the, isn't there a hand signal alphabet, something like this, for people with hearing impediments? Right. I think there are things that are kind of, yeah, normed or kind of international. Probably we don't know them, we use them naturally, but there is a definition for certain hand signals.
Yeah, there are a couple, American Sign Language, and there are a couple of different sort of schools of sign language available where it's either spelled out the word is spelled out, or there's a gesture that represents the word or phrase.
Well, perfect. I want to respect everyone's time, but I just want to thank you so much for joining. Yes, see, behavior. I just want to say so much for joining and your time and attention. And to close out, we'll do a one hand signal checkout. So let's put 15 seconds on the clock. Think of a hand signal, appreciative hand gesture for someone in session or an idea that you're walking away with. And then we will share that on when I count down from three, or when I give the signal, we'll all share that. Okay. So 15 seconds on the clock, think of a hand gesture, an appreciative hand gesture, and don't share it until I give the indication. All right. So I'm going to count down from three, and then we're all going to share and get a screenshot, I suppose. Or maybe not. All right.
A GIF. Butter makes a GIF for us because we're on camera.
3, 2, 1, share. Thank you so much, everyone.
I don't know that everyone's with their mouth open. Is that a...
hope to connect on LinkedIn. Or some other space, but thank you so much. If you want to provide feedback, you can send me a note. It was a little experimental, but I learned a lot and hope you did too.
Thank you, Chris. Yeah. 10 out of 10.
Yeah, the fist of five, that's so stupid. Like, I don't know how I missed fist of five for voting. So silly.
That's okay. Next time, Chris. Gosh. Thank you very much for bringing this experimental session, this playground here for us to chew on. Thank you, everyone, for joining today. It was awesome to see you and have an amazing rest of the day. Kisses and hugs to y'all, and see you on the next butter session. Stay awesome.
Thank you so much, everyone.